Hello, thanks for joining. My name is Eric Beauchamp. I am the product manager for low vision devices here at HumanWare. Today, we'll be learning about the new handwriting tool in Prodigy 2.2. Now, let's say my teacher has given me an assignment, and I would like to write on it and submit it to my teacher. The thing to do is place the document underneath the Connect 12, go into Magnifier. I would like to have a full page capture, so I'm going to zoom out. There we go. I will capture the document. And as you notice, the third button from the left has changed. It's not only to save, but there's also an edit button underneath. So in order to be able to edit my document, I will tap on the save button because I need to save my document first. Now that my document has been saved, I can zoom in. And if I want, I prefer working just in color, and I will zoom in to where I have to write my name on top of the document. There we go. This is where I want to write my name. So what I do is that I click on the pen or pencil icon or button right here, which is the third button from the left on the button banner. And by doing so, we are in the editing mode of the document. We have several buttons that just have been displayed. The first one on the left is the back button. The second one from the left is a pen. So that means that the pen is activated and we can start writing on the document right away. The third button is the eraser button. The fourth button is the color palette button. And the fifth and final button on the button banner is the thickness button to be able to change the thickness of my pen. Now, since I am in the pen mode, I can start writing my name where I need to. So I'm going to write my name, Eric. And then to pan in edit mode in the document, I'm going to use a two-finger pan. So I'm going to put my two fingers on the document and start panning in the document. I can zoom out if I'd like to with a pinch and zoom, and then pan to my first question here that I have to answer, which is 1 + 1, and I need to enter my answer in the box. So I'm going to zoom in where I want to have my answer, and I want to write my answer here, 2. Now, as you see, I did a mistake there, and I can erase that mistake by going into the button banner and selecting the eraser button, which is the third button from the left. Once I did this, I can go on top of what I want to erase, and it's going to erase it. To go out of my eraser mode, I have to click on the erase button again. Okay, so let's say I want to change the palette, the color of what I am writing with. Let's choose red. There's a couple of options here. So I'm going to choose red, and I'm going to pan in my document and answer the second question here, which is 2 + 1 = 3. And again, the thickness, the last button, I can choose the thickness of how I'm going to be writing with the pen. There's also another option, a highlighter option, so I can highlight a sentence or a word in my document. And to do this, I'm going to tap on the second button from the left. Now that button changed. The icon on the button changed. That means I'm in the highlighter mode. So what I'm going to do, I want to highlight my title. And by default, it's going to be yellow. So I'll be highlighting right here, both of my lines here. If I don't want the second line to be highlighted, I can erase my highlight by selecting the eraser button and going on top of what I have highlighted. And then once I'm done, click on the eraser button again. There's also another option in order to write text with a keyboard. To do this, I tap on the highlighter button, and that button is going to change to a big T. Now, if I want to have my name written, Eric Van Boscha, in using the keypad, I'm going to press and hold where I want my text, and the keyboard shows up in another form with a text box. So I'm going to write my family name. Once I'm done, I click or I tap on the button on the top right corner of the screen, which is a paper airplane, and that added some text to my document. Now this text is a bit too big, so what I want to do, I'm going to tap on it to select it, and I'm going to do a pinch and zoom to reduce the size of that text. If I want to move it around, you just drag the text of where I want to place my text. Once I'm done, click anywhere in the document and the highlight over or the selected text will be unselected, and we can continue to edit inside my document. Once I'm done, I do a black, and that's going to save automatically to my gallery all my modifications. Let's say I want to share, I'm done with this and I want to share it with my teacher. What I need to do is go back to my main menu, go into gallery and find my document, which is right here. Press and hold on my document, and the first action in the action menu will be share. So if I click on share, it will bring me to several applications that I can use to share my document. I can use Gmail, I can save it on my Google Drive. If I have Dropbox installed, my Dropbox would be in the list. And if I have an application to send it to a printer, that application would be also in the list. Now, the document that's going to be shared is going to be in a JPEG format for now, as a first version of this handwriting tool. So you'll be sending a JPEG over to your teacher or the printer or wherever you want to share it. And that's it. Thank you for listening.